experiments. And from this we can conclude that in order to eliminate the earlier inhibition, we have to inactivate P53 pathway and repress the apoptosis. Probably the same happens when we remove P53, because P53 is one of the major causes of the apoptosis, or major regulators of apoptosis in the cell. But we proved, okay, the RP is really important for all of these regulations, and we decided to check the status of RB in naked molar cells. First of all, it was quite challenging to find the antibodies which work in naked molar, but we succeeded and we confirmed several different antibodies that this is really RB, what we can see on those cells. The short reminder about the status of RB is existed in two stages. Active RB will bind E2F, a transcriptional factor, and take the cells out of the cell cycle, the cell cycle at stage. And then the phosphorylated RB is inactive stage, the E2F is released and the cells go into the cell cycle. And here is our reference of the human skin fibroblasts and the growing cells. We have a mixture of inactivated or phosphorylated RB and active RB. And confluent stage, we have only active RB stage. Now let's look at naked morad. We can see, okay, growing culture, we have inactivated RB. Confluent culture, we have inactivated RB and growing culture, and activated and confluent cells. And it's the same for lung and skin, maybe less prominent, but active RB. It's clear that RB gets regulated specifically in naked morad cells. What we know about regulation of RB, probably most of you know it, but this I just want to remind, that RB is regulated by cyclin CDK, a cyclin-dependent kinases complexes, and this complex is regulated by CDKI, cyclin-dependent kinase inhibitors. And we are going after these guys, naked morad cells. Again, it took some time to find the right antibodies for naked morad. But we succeeded, and first we look on P27, KIP1. And we can see it gets activated in human cells, it's growing, confluent, nicely activated. Mouse cell, lung and skin, we get nice activation of P27. But in naked molar, if you look on skin and lung fibroblasts, you can see a mild activation of P27. In the beginning I was thinking, yeah, maybe this antibody doesn't recognize a naked molar protein really well. But look, this is a mutant, if you remember, that's a mutant naked morad cell line, which is growing to the normal inhibition level. You can see the high level of P27, they're comparable to the mouse. It means it's not a problem of specificity of P27. This level of induction of P27 is really, really low, what you can observe here. And then we checked really famous protein, and everyone was talking yesterday about this, P16-INC4A. And it's not activated by cone inhibition in human and mouse cells. Here you can see the traces of the proteins in these cells. But look what happened in naked molar cells. It's clearly got activated in primary cultures at confluence. I think you're saying the lung and skin fibroblasts. But interestingly, this is the mutated naked molar cells. We cannot see any P16 there. And actually, we confirmed by RT-PCR that it's no mRNA present. And we think, we would like to think actually, that one of the mutations is spontaneously mutagenized naked molar cell lines, it's probably silencing of P16. It's called mutation or methylation of P16 locus. It means what we are talking about, this mechanism in naked molar, actually let's talk first about human and mouse. When we have the cells growing, we have an increase of the cell density when they reach a certain level. Could be in tissue, in our case in tissue culture, they trigger the activation of P27, KIP1 protein, which triggers the regulation, regular contact inhibition. In case of naked molar, we have the two barriers, two anti-cancer mechanisms. One is the first when the cells get lower cell density, it means when the cells just start touching each other in the culture, or probably in the tissues, and we have the activation of P16 in IN4A, and it triggers earlier contact inhibition. If the P16 gets silenced by mutation or methylation, then cells will progress to higher cell density and the P27 gets kicked in as in our mutated cell lines and cells go into regular inhibition. It means it's two tight control anti-cancer mechanism. But this is a nice model, how we can prove it. The way to prove it actually, this model predicted naked molar primary cells should be more resistant to tumorigenic transformation. And that's what we decided to test it. We just took the primary fibroblast. and start to grow in a soft agar. That's a standard test for tumorigenicity of the tissues. And say we took the mouse skin fibroblasts, we transfect them, this is our control GFP and LHT. Usually what we know from a mouse, target cells will not immortalize in this stage. And they will not be able to form the big colonies, it's like single double cells on the culture. If you put the oncogenic RAS and eliminate the P53 or RB proteins, the cells start to grow in a soft agar, like forming some kind of tumors. In case we eliminate the whole pathways, RB and P53 at the same time, oncogenic RAS, you get a bigger colony. But this is enough for transformation, malignant transformation of mouse fibroblasts. And now let's look what happened to naked mora skin fibroblasts. None of the condition can transform naked mora cells. You can see some small colonies, like 2 to 3 cells, but they are not the biggest mouse. And interestingly, we did the same experiment with our mutated naked mora fibroblast, dead cell line, which probably get the silence of P53. And you can see the nice transformation, even when we just put the RAS and remove the P53, and also RB proteins. It means, yes, the mouse cells, they are more resistant to oncogenic transformation than the mouse cell. And that's probably due to this double control of the contact inhibition in naked mora. But so far what I was talking about, it was the results from the tissue cultures. The question, what happened in the real tissues? How does it look? How cells look like? And how this earlier contribution applies to the normal tissues? And this is just the beginning of the project, because we looked only on one tissue, the skin. This electron microscope photographs of the keratinocytes from mouse and naked mora. Actually, what you can see here, it's a huge nucleus. And that's a second cell. And that's the boundary between the two cells. If you can see it, this is tight junctions here. The two membranes come together. That's another tight junction, it's another tight junction. And the membranes in between these two spaces, they're going like parallels. The membranes, they're like close to each other. Look what happened in naked mora. Again, the two keratinocytes, two cell nucleus, again, these two cells. And look in the space. This is one tight junction. Here, there's one tight junction, and that's the other tight junction. There's a huge space in between. The cells like pushing each other from, they don't like to be close to each other. They're feeling some kind of, I know, we like to call it cytoplasmic fingers, where they are actually pushing each other from. That may reflect this earlier contribution of we see in the culture, in the tissue culture. And of course, we are going to look on other tissues and see how it reflects what happened in the liver, what is the next stages. That's a few more electron microscope photographs. Again, you see this huge spaces filled with the cytoplasmic fingers. We don't know exactly the structure of that. And just in summary, what I just told you about, the naked mora, they have this unique mechanism of early contact inhibition that serves additional anti-cancer mechanism in naked mora. The second, that we know that embryonic fibroblasts, they don't have early contact inhibition, but it kicks in later in development. We don't know which stage exactly, but it becomes present in cells. And earlier contact inhibition is controlled by both P53 and RB pathways and associated with upregulation of P16 and INF4A. And most likely, that probably the role of P53 is just the apoptosis. It kills the cells who escape the earlier contact inhibition of the extra layer of this mechanism. And the preliminary results from the tissues that are naked mora skin keratinocytes, they have the big spaces between the cells, which probably correspond to our early contact inhibition if you're absorbing the tissue culture. And I would like to thank all the students who was involved in this project, especially Chris and Jorge. And I would like to thank my lifetime collaborator, Vera Gorbunova, actually, who's going to speak tomorrow at 9 a.m. And she's going to talk about more rodents, because we have a big collection. Naked mora is just only part of lab. And we have a collection of 18 rodents. And she's going to talk about the evolution of anti-cancer mechanism in big rodent family. And my research is funded by Alison Medical Foundation.